إن الحمد لله، نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره، ونعوذ بالله تعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن سيدنا وحبيبنا وعظيمنا وشفيعنا وأسوتنا وقدوتنا ومعلمنا محمدًا عبده ورسوله. بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح للأمة، وكشف الله عز وجل به الغمة، وجاهد في سبيل دينه حتى آتاه الله اليقين. فاللهم اجزه عنا وعن والدينا خير ما جزيت به نبيًا عن قومه، ورسولًا عن أمته، وأوردنا حوضه، واسقنا بيديه الشريفتين شربة هنيئة مريئة لا نظمأ بعدها أبدا. آمين آمين يا رب العالمين. محمد بلغ العلا بكماله، كشف الدجى بجماله، حسنت جميع خصاله، صلوا عليه وآله. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي، يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته، ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة، وخلق منها زوجها، وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا، يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار، وما قل وكفى خير مما كثر وألها. My dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, salamullahi alaykum wa rahmatuhu wa barakatuh. All praise is due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And whoever Allah guides, none can misguide. And whoever Allah permits to misguide, none can guide. I bear witness that there is no God worthy of worship but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is his messenger and the last messenger he sent to mankind to guide them to the right path. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide us all to the right path, ya Rabbil Alameen. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive our sins. Ameen, ameen, ya Rabbil Alameen. My dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, when we talk about the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as we said before, that must be the most beautiful khutbahs ever. Because we're talking about the best of all creation, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And the way actually I prepared that khutbah, or this khutbah, I was listening to the radio. It was like the United Nations, they identified that there are a lot of problems and issues and problems all over the world nowadays, and they're trying, you know, to work on it. And when I listened to some of these problems and issues, I found out that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam could easily handle these problems and issues. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in his time, and Al-Quran has many solutions, has solutions for these problems and crises. Because that is the true religion. That is the religion that you should be proud of. When we talk about this topic, which is the sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, we bring the pride to your heart. You should be proud of being Muslim. Do not hide your identity. Do not change your name just to hide your identity. You don't want people to recognize you as Muslim. What a shame. That the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam has been through these hardships, and he conveyed the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to us, and we abandon that, and we don't feel proud of the religion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala,
we are held accountable on the Day of Judgment in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for each and everything. My dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, the prophetic model, the solution to the universal issues, the solution for the universal and the global problems. Let's learn from the Quran. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala spoke about the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ, that we have not sent you but an unconditional mercy to the universe, to everyone. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is a mercy for everyone, not only for Muslims, for human beings. وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ. We need to understand the religion the way the Sahaba understood it from the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We need to learn the religion and have the religion the way they had it. They were proud of being Muslims. They migrated to Abyssinia to tell the king over there that they are Muslims, and how blessed they are because the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam became a messenger, and he was sent by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to be the last messenger. We learn the religion and understand it from Ja'far ibn Abi Talib. He was the spokesperson in that delegation when they migrated to Al-Habasha. He came to the king, and the king summoned him. He said, come and tell me about that religion. What is it the reason that made you embrace that religion? What is it the reason that made you not embrace or not embracing these or other religions, Christianity or these people who worship the idols? What is it the reason that actually made you love the religion? So Ja'far ibn Abi Talib, we need to listen to that presentation of Ja'far ibn Abi Talib, because that is the understanding that we need to have. The first thing, as Ummu Salama narrated, she said, قال جعفر أيها الملك. Then Ja'far came to that king, An-Najashi, and he said, oh, you're the king. Oh, you're the highest. Oh, you're the majesty. Oh, you're the king. كنا قوما أهل جاهلية, that we were in total and complete ignorance. We used to live in ignorance. نعبد الأصنام. He's talking about his people before the advent of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We used to worship idols. We used to worship the creation, not the creator. No matter, it might be the creation, physical creation, might be something, some idols or gods that you imagine in your mind, might be worshiping the money, worshiping the family, worshiping the dunya, and you forget about the hereafter. So might be metaphorical and literal. We used to worship the idols, the creation, not the creator. We used to eat the dead bodies, also metaphorical or literal. You can eat the flesh of a dead body by committing backbiting or gossip, talking about somebody else or talking ill. That is called in the Arabic language eating the dead body, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the Quran. And he said, وَنَأْتِ الْفَوَاحِشِ, and if we could find a way to commit an evil, we do it. Like it's not a problem about it is it evil or not, but the problem is about getting or finding a way to commit that evil. We used to do that. Ja'far is presenting the religion of Islam to An-Najashi. If we could find a way to commit an evil, we do it. Then he said, وَنَقْطَعُ الْأَرْحَامِ, and we used to cut the ties of kinship. We used to hate each other. You have a problem with your brother, you hate him. A problem with the sister, you hate her. We used to cut the ties. When you see Uljiwar, and we were not good neighbors. And the Prophet ﷺ taught us how to be good neighbors. And he said, وَيَأْكُلُ الْقَوِيُّ مِنَّ الضَّعِيفِ, that the powerful man amongst us would kill and eat the rights of the weak amongst us. Then he said, وَكُنَّا عَلَى ذَٰلِكَ حَتَّى بَعَثَ إِلَيْنَا رَسُولًا. Then we were doing that until Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent to us a messenger and a prophet from amongst ourselves. We know who he is. نَعْرِفُ نَسَبَهُ وَصِدْقَهُ. We know that he is trustworthy. We know that he is truthful. وَأَمَانَتَهُ. We know that he is honest. وَعَفَافَهُ. That he does not like to be in a lower level of life. He is trustworthy. He is the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Then he called upon us. He asked us to believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لِنُوَحِّدَهُ وَنَعْبُدَهُ. To worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To observe tawheed. Say la ilaha illallah and Muhammadur Rasulullah. See the presentation here. He's telling him to compare between their life before the advent of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and their life after the coming of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He used to do that. And he said, and he asked us to leave what we used to worship. Leave these idols. And worship only Allah. La ilaha illallah. Not to worship any creation. Not to worship money. Not to worship nothing in this dunya. Not to worship this dunya. But you worship only Allah, the Creator, who has created you. And He takes care of you. He is Allah. La ilaha illahu. Then He said, وَأَمَرَنَا بِصِدْقِ الْحَدِيثِ. He asked us to be truthful. He taught us to be truthful, to tell the truth, no matter what. Is that good or bad? He's talking to the king. He's telling us to say the truth and to stay away of the falsehood, forgery. We don't tell lies because we are Muslims. We are believers. We submit ourselves to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he taught us to maintain the ties of kinship. Silatul Rahim. And he taught us to be good neighbor. And he taught us to stop committing evil. And to stop shedding the blood. That was the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is teaching the humanity. He's teaching each and every one on the face of this earth. We should learn from the sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And he forbade us to eat the money or the wealth of orphans. The rights of orphans. And he ordered us to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. And in the end of the hadith, and you can think about it and ponder what Ja'far ibn Abi Talib said. In the end of the hadith, he sealed the conversation by what? He said in the end, وَأَمَرَنَا بِالصَّلَاةِ وَالصِّيَامِ وَالْقِيَامِ بِالصَّلَاةِ وَالصِّيَامِ وَالزَّكَاةِ. That after all of that, in the end, الصَّلَاةِ, then as-siyam, then as-zakah. Like our religion is all about good manners. Like our religion is all about these things that I just mentioned. Being good to the neighbors. Do not cut the ties of kinship. Follow the sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Worship Allah alone. Do not worship creation. Worship the Creator. This is our religion. And in the end, you pray. You do the siyam. You fast, you pay your zakah. That is our religion. If your prayer does not stop you from committing the evil, then what is the point? أُتْلُ مَا أُوحِيَ إِلَيْكَ مِنَ الْكِتَابِ وَأَقِمِ الصَّلَاةِ. That establish your prayer. إِنَّ الصَّلَاةَ تَنْهَى عَنِ الْفَحْشَاءِ وَالْمُنْكَرِ. That the salah should stop you from committing the evil, from committing the sins. The global issues I have looked at and identified about 14 and 15 of them. I'll try to summarize as much as I can, inshallah. The first thing, the first problem and issue that the UN said, they said it is poverty. Poverty. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam tackled and handled that very well, to the extent that he used to make the dua, Allahumma inni a'udhu bika min al-kufri wal-faqr. Like, Allah, oh Allah, I seek refuge to you from poverty and from disbelief. He used to make the dua sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he used to teach the companions that the best food As was narrated in Al-Bukhari, the best food that you could eat is the food that you make it with your hand. That you plant it, that you make it, that you work and you get your money and buy your food. That is the best food. Prophet ﷺ here is fighting poverty. He said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, لِأَنْ يَحْتَطِبَ أَحَدُكُمْ. If you take some wood, or you go and take a rope, and you bring some wood from the desert, some wood from anywhere, from the wooden area, and you go and sell that in the market, and you bring money, and you eat from it, that is the best thing ever. It's better than asking people, they might give or deprive you. خَيْرٌ لَهُ مِنْ أَنْ يَسْأَلِ النَّاسِ أَعْطَوْهُ أَوْ مَنَعُوهُ. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is teaching us to fight poverty through charity and paying the zakah. إِنَّ كَثِيرًا مِنَ الْأَحْبَارِ وَالرُّهْبَانِ لَيَأْكُلُونَ أَمْوَالَ النَّاسِ بِالْبَاطِلِ وَيَصُدُّونَ عَنْ سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ وَالَّذِينَ يَكْنِزُونَ الذَّهَبَ وَالْفِضَّةِ. Those who withhold and they don't pay the zakah, they don't pay charity, you don't share. As we always say, sharing is caring, giving is loving, giving is living. When you care about people, according to the hadith of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, مَن لَمْ يَهْتَمَّ بِأَمْرِ الْمُسْلِمِينَ فَلَيْسَ مِنْهُمْ. The one who does not care about Muslims, he is not one of them. Number two, they said, disease or diseases. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and the Quran taught us how to care for the special needs. How to care for them. Before anybody else, our religion taught us how to care for them. Care about them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, لَيْسَ عَلَى الْأَعْمَى حَرَجٌ. Like facilitate for those who are blind. وَلَا عَلَى الْمَرِيضِ حَرَجٌ. وَلَا عَلَى الْأَعْرَجِ حَرَجٌ. Like facilitate for those who are sick. For those who limp, facilitate, make it easy for them to the extent that fasting is obligatory, mandatory. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made those who are sick, who can't make it, they are exempt. You don't have to fast. Religion is easy. We care about the special needs. لَيْسَ عَلَى الْأَعْمَى حَرَجٌ وَلَا عَلَى الْمَرِيضِ حَرَجٌ. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught us to fight diseases. He said, تَدَاوَوْ يَا عِبَادَ اللَّهِ. Like seek remedy. Seek the healing. يَا عِبَادَ اللَّهِ. Or servants of Allah. O creation, seek the remedy. And the Prophet ﷺ used to teach the companions to use honey. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, فِيهِ شِفَاءُ لِلنَّاسِ. Isn't that a kind of cure and remedy for these diseases? That's mentioned in the Quran. And the Prophet ﷺ used to teach the companions to use sadaqah also to become recovered or to become, you know, cured from these diseases. Number three, they said, food and agriculture. Building lands on top of the agriculture land. Building houses, concrete, cement, whatever. Because people are growing. See, there is a problem. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran, He told us, وَآيَةٌ لَهُمُ الْأَرْضُ الْمَيْتَةُ أَحْيَيْنَاهَا وَأَخْرَجْنَا مِنْهَا حَبًّا فَمِنْهُ يَأْكُلُونَ. That's, it's a miracle. It's a sign for you that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave you this dead land. Once you put the seed, it becomes alive. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives life to this land. فَمِنْهُ يَأْكُلُونَ. Then you eat from it. And the Prophet ﷺ taught the companions, if you have land and you don't work it, work it. Give it to somebody else to work it, to use it. You don't use it, give it to somebody else to use it. And the Prophet ﷺ said, مَا مِن مُسْلِمْ يَغْرِسُ غَرْسًا. That if you plant anything on the face of this earth and you eat from it, that's a sadaqah. What do you mean by planting and eating? I plant and eat myself. Yes, it's a sadaqah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will write it as a sadaqah for you. It's a charity. If somebody else is stole from it, this food is stolen, it's a sadaqah for you also. If the animals came and ate the food, it's a sadaqah for you also. مَا مِن مُسْلِمْ يَغْرِسُ غَرْسًا.
And the Prophet ﷺ taught us, even if the final hour is over, or the final hour comes, when the final hour comes, the day of judgment, Qiyamah comes, and you're holding in your hand a palm tree, small, cut tree, then you need to plant it, no matter who's going to use it and who's not. You need to plant it. You need to benefit people. Number four, they said violence. Number five, they said weapons of mass destruction. Violence, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to warn Muslims and the companions against holding a metal piece to threaten people. He said, "Man rawwa'a musliman," like he who threatens people, he who threatens his brother holding or using a piece of metal, al-mala'ikatu tal'anu, the angels will curse him. Subhanallah. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam taught the companions how to develop the weapons of mass construction, not mass destruction. Mass instruction. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to teach the companions how to be peaceful. Number six, education. It's a problem. And when it comes to education, what is it the first ayah that was revealed to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Read. Iqra. Our religion is the religion of knowledge. Religion of education. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Talabul ilmi fariida." That seeking the knowledge is an obligation. Mandatory. No matter how expensive that is, you choose education or ignorance. You should be an educated Muslim. You should seek the knowledge. طَلَبُ الْعِلْمِ فَرِيضَةً لَكُلِّ مُسْلِمٍ وَمُسْلِمَةً. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us understanding, Ya Rabbil Alameen. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us all. أَقُولُ قَوْلِي هَذَا وَأَسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهِ. الحمد لله رب العالمين. والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الخلق وسيد المرسلين سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent the Prophet ﷺ, spoke about him in Surah Al-Jumu'ah, he said, وَيُعَلِّمُهُمُ الْكِتَابَ وَالْحِكْمَةِ, and teach them the book and the hikmah and the sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Number seven, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, do not use your power to threaten people. Like, وَلَا تَعْتَدُوا إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُحِبُّ الْمُعْتَدِينَ. Do not transgress. Allah does not like those who are transgressors. Allah does not like those who are oppressors. وَلَا تَعْتَدُوا إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُحِبُّ الْمُعْتَدِينَ. He said, إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ لَيَطْغَى. Like, the human being are like becoming more transgressors. Those people are becoming more transgressors. أَرَّآهُ اسْتَغْنَى. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Al-Alaq, إِنَّ إِلَى رَبِّكَ الرُّجْعَى. You will be back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You think that you're transgressing people and you're becoming an oppressor in this dunya. You won't be back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's because you don't have the deen. You don't have the religion. You will be back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And you won't talk then when you go back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But there is something else that will talk. What is it? يَوْمَ تَشْهَدُ عَلَيْهِمْ أَلْسِنَتُهُمْ وَأَيْدِيهِمْ وَأَرْجُلُهُمْ بِمَا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ. That your tongues will talk. وَأَيْدِيهِمْ, your hands will talk. Your leg will talk. Everything, your skin will talk in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Number nine, number eight, democracy and consultation. They say it's a problem. In our religion, there is something that is called shura, consultation. فَبِمَا رَحْمَةٍ مِّنَ اللَّهِ لِنْتَ لَهُمْ وَلَوْ كُنْتَ فَضًّا غَلِيظَ الْقَلْبِ لَمْ فَضُّوا مِنْ حَوْلِكَ. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَعْفُ عَنْهُمْ, forgive them, وَشَاوِرْهُمْ فِي الْأَمْرِ, share the decision making with them. Like, let them consult you and consult them. This is our religion. Number 10, family and family values. Number 9, before I get to 10, sorry, the environment. The environment, they say it's a problem. And the environment is getting polluted. A lot of pollution. And Al-Quran, he mentioned, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned that in the Quran. ظَهَرَ الْفَسَادُ فِي الْبَرِّ وَالْبَحْرِ بِمَا كَسَبَتْ أَيْدِ النَّاسِ. That the corruption, that there is corruption on the face of the earth and also in the sea. Now people say, well, the fish is getting, dying and stuff because of the pollution that is in the environment. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned that in the Quran. He said, ظَهَرَ الْفَسَادُ فِي الْبَرِّ وَالْبَحْرِ. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, من محاسن هذه الأمة إماطة الأذى عن الطريق. Like one of the beautiful things that my ummah has been given is removing the pollution from the roads, removing the harmful objects from the road. That's our religion. إماطة الأذى عن الطريق صدقة. Number 10, family and family values. The first thing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, from the beginning of the creation, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, يا آدم اسكن أنت وزوجك الجنة. Like live you and your spouse. He's putting the rules for the family. You together, you share the life together. اسكن أنت وزوجك الجنة. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَجَعَلَ بَيْنَكُمْ مَوَدَّةً وَرَحْمَةً. Number 11, the human values. This Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلَقَدْ كَرَّمْنَا بَنِي آدَمْ. We have dignified human beings. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed us and dignified us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِنَّ دِمَاءَكُمْ وَأَمْوَالَكُمْ وَأَعْرَاضَكُمْ حَرَامٌ عَلَيْكُمْ. Like your blood, your reputation, your money, your wealth are very sacred. Haram. Just like the sacredness of that day. He was on the day of Arafah, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Number 12, women rights. That's in our religion. وَلَهُنَّ مِثْلُ الَّذِي عَلَيْهِنَّ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, they share the same rulings. The husband and the wife. وَلَهُنَّ مِثْلُ الَّذِي عَلَيْهِنَّ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّا خَلَقْنَاكُمْ مِنْ ذَكَرٍ وَأُنْثَى. خَلَقْنَاكُمْ, we created you, males and females. وَجَعَلْنَاكُمْ شُعُوبًا وَقَبَائِلَ. Then in the end, إِنَّ أَكْرَمَكُمْ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ أَتْقَاكُمْ. That the most pious man, the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is the most beloved one. He is the most honored one when you're closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Number 13, plant rights. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he spoke about the garden that you plant in, he said, it's Jannah. He said, وَلَوْلَا إِذْ دَخَلْتَ جَنَّتَكَ. It's your Jannah. So protect it and save it. إِذَا قَامَتِ السَّاعَةِ, when the final hour comes and you can plant, plant. Number 14, the animal rights. We all know that a man entered Jannah because of what? He brought the water for a thirsty dog. And a woman entered the hellfire because of what? She can find the cat and she didn't give the cat the food or the drink. That is the woman, the plant or the animal rights. Number 14 or 15, the refugee rights. And we learn that from Al-Ansar and Al-Muhajireen. وَالَّذِينَ تَبَوَّأُوا الدَّارَ وَالْإِيمَانَ مِنْ قَبْلِهِمْ يُحِبُّونَ مَنْ هَاجَرَ إِلَيْهِمْ. They love those who migrate to them. They smile at their faces. They don't show grumpy faces. They say, you are a refugee, you don't live here, this is not your country or something. No. This يُحِبُّونَ مَنْ هَاجَرَ إِلَيْهِمْ وَلَا يَجِدُونَ فِي صُدُورِهِمْ حَاجَةٍ. They don't have anything in their hearts but peace and love. They love them. You want to share everything with them. And we know the whole story. And the number 16 that actually was not mentioned in the UN, I just came up with it, is the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam came to spread the love. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam came in a time where the world was love deprived. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi brought the love. He said, لا تؤمنوا حتى تحابوا. You will never believe until you love each other. And he said, أَلَا أَدُلُّكُمْ عَلَى شَيْءٍ إِذَا فَعَلْتُمُوهُ تَحَبَبْتُمْ. I'll tell you something, if you do, you will love each other. What is it? Say, assalamu alaykum. Now the universe, the world is love deprived. We need to put the love back and bring the love back from the sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us understanding, ya Rabbil Alameen. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us proud of our religion, ya Rabbil Alameen. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala strengthen and purify our hearts, ya Rabbil Alameen. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us all, ameen, ameen, ya Rabbil Alameen. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward us all, ya Rabbil Alameen. Allahumma ighfir lana dhunubana wa israfana fi amrina wa thabbit aqdamana wa ansurna ala alqawm alkafirin. Allahumma la tad'a lana dhanban illa ghafarta. ولا هما إلا فرجته ولا دينا إلا قضيته ولا مريضا إلا شفيته ولا ميتا إلا رحمته ولا مظلوما إلا نصرته ولا ظالما إلا هديته ولا حاجة من حوائج الدنيا لك فيها رضا ولا فيها صلاح إلا قضيتها ويسرتها يا رب العالمين. وأقم الصلاة إن الصلاة كانت على المؤمنين كتابا موقوتا.
الله أكبر الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. أشهد أن محمد رسول الله. حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح. قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة. الله أكبر الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله.
استوى تدرون.
Allahu Akbar. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim, Malik Yawm Al-Din, Iyaka Na'budu Wa Iyaka Nasta'in, Ihdina الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين. وآية لهم الأرض الميتة أحييناها وأخرجنا منها حبا فمنه يأكلون وجعلنا فيها جنات من نخيل وأعناب وفجرنا فيها من العيون ليأكلوا من ثمره وما عملته أيديهم أفلا يشكرون سبحان الذي خلق الأزواج كلها مما تنبت الأرض ومن أنفسهم ومما لا يعلمون الله الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين. قل هو الله أحد الله الصمد لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد